Hi guys, and welcome to Ask Tatiana. My name is Tatiana Ryshkova, and today I would like to talk with you about how you can succeed without teacher. So first, let's start with the question, what actually the teacher does? What are his or her functions? And why it might be so helpful for us? So the first point is definitely feedback. The teacher gives you feedback about what works well already and what are the trouble spots. Some of them you maybe even don't notice by yourself or need much more time to notice that, but he or she will give you the answer much faster. The second point is solution of problems. Problems could be of different kind. That might be technical problems, that might be musical problems like interpretation, how to make dynamic, all these things. And that could be also motivation problems. The teacher helps you to go up again after the usual downs that everybody of us have, and that is absolutely fine. The next point is the teacher helps to build up the repertoire. So the teacher takes care about the pieces you have already played before, and it helps you with advice as how you can keep it fresh in the memory or in the fingers so you will not forget them. Another point, strategy. We are talking now, of course, not about each teacher, we talk about good teaching, very good teaching. So in my opinion, each good teacher should be able to make some kind of a plan how you can achieve your goal. So for example, when you come to teacher and says, oh, I'm a beginner, but I would like to play Asturias. The teacher makes some kind of a plan for you, what you should start with, how much time you would need. Maybe you will not get this plan printed, but the teacher will keep it in mind, giving you some homework and so far. And the last point helps to avoid injuries. Very important one. The teacher helps and sees immediately what are the bad habits that you have and what you need to do to avoid the injuries and to be able to play longer and happier. Of course, this is only some kind of a concentrate of few things, and I'm very much looking forward to your comments. Please continue with this list. What, in your opinion, are the things that a good teacher should do? Now we go to the point what you should do or what you should learn to do if you work without a teacher. The first point is self-reflection. Here we have the feedback that the teacher gives you, and here you need to learn to give this feedback to yourself. How does it work? It might be not so easy, because to be able to do a good self-reflection, you need to know very well what are the things you are good at and what are the things you're bad at, or the things that you would like to develop and to succeed. That might be sometimes not so easy to say, actually, I cannot do this. It's much easier to keep the illusion, or actually didn't work only now, but actually I can do it. But to be very honest with yourself is absolutely must have to be able to succeed. There are also some helpful tools that you can use to get this good self-reflection. Of course, these are audio and video recordings. You don't need super expensive equipment to be able to do that. That is absolutely enough to do these recordings just with your mobile phone. Works perfectly, and then you have already the good impression of reality and not of your illusion in the head. Another tool that could help you to get the self-reflection is using mirror. If you have a big mirror, or if you don't have that, then you can put just your mobile phone and switch it in the selfie mode. That works perfectly, so you can see yourself well. That is very helpful if you want to check some technical details, the position of the hands, if you keep your hand right, if the fingers maybe fly too far away, if you have any hidden tension in the fingers. All these things you can control by yourself using a mirror. And another thing that could help you to get this self-reflection is to compare your playing with somebody else. How does it work? Usually we open YouTube, and when we started to learn a piece, we find any recording. And here I can encourage you not just only to listen to this recording and to think, oh, it sounds great, why I cannot do like that. More helpful would be if you study the music with the scores, listen to the music, listen to the interpretation you have on YouTube and you like on YouTube with the scores, and trying to get in the depth to understand what is actually this thing that I like so much in these recordings. Because from the general feeling I like it, you need to go very concrete. You need to understand what exactly do you like. Do you like the speed? Do you like the accent? Do you like that he or she performs loud? Do you like the dynamical changes? Do you like how legato it sounds? There could be many, many things. And as long as you don't know exactly what you like, what you prefer, you will not be able to apply it in your playing. So scores helps a lot to follow and to compare the general impression, to bring it to something concrete. And there we come to the second important point. You need to learn to concretize the problem. That is one of the probably the most difficult things that are really hard to learn if you don't have the teacher, but it's definitely something that will open you many doors. If you have a technical problem, very often it sounds like the students say to me, I know I have here a problem, I cannot play this bar, or somehow I cannot play these three lines. But that's it. That is actually where the students usually stops. And that is the point that will not bring you further. If you notice, I cannot play this part well, it's not helpful for you. What you need to know, why you cannot play that well, why you are not able to manage it. You need to go to the very, very specific things and to figure out what is it, what it doesn't work. Maybe this is the specific chord progression, and even chord progression is not concrete enough. You need to check which chords exactly don't work. And what in the chord doesn't work? Sometimes that might be one or two fingers that are too late. Or sometimes the position change itself doesn't work. Or sometimes you just don't know which is the second chord that you play, and because of that you have a big gap. So these are the examples of being very concrete. And if you know exactly if it's position, if it it's memory, if it's something else, you will have absolutely different ways of work and of practicing. As long as you stay at this general, I cannot play it, you will not be able to solve the problem. As I said, it might be very difficult, and because of that, it is good to have a teacher at your side that will be easier, but you can learn it. Next point, build up the repertoire. In this case, you are responsible by yourself for your personal repertoire. To be able to build it up, there are many things what you can do. First of all, that's great just to write down all the pieces you have ever played, or to write down and then to mark your favorite pieces. Then you will see already, that is probably something that I can keep in my repertoire. Then it's good to repeat these pieces regularly, so to build this repetition in your practicing sessions. And regularly, I mean not once a month, maybe once a week or twice a week, just to play the piece through to be sure you keep it in mind. What is also very nice and helpful, to make recordings of the pieces as soon as they are ready. That is great memory for you, and that is nice thing to come back to when you would like to build up your repertoire. Next point, make a plan. It is something like strategy with the teacher. You would need to make a plan what you want to learn. That is also quite difficult to do it if you have never done this, but it's definitely worth a try. Ask yourself, you started to play guitar, why? What do you like to learn? What are the techniques that fascinate you? What are the pieces that you would like to play? Just fix it somehow on the paper, on the telephone. Write it down. There is always some kind of a map. You would keep it better in mind why you do it. And from time to time, you can correct it and apply some other things, to add some other things. And last but not least point, inform yourself about bad habits. That is something very important when you work without a teacher. Before you get any injury, I would recommend you in the beginning, if you're absolutely healthy and young or old, doesn't matter, if you feel absolutely fit, when you start to learn the instrument, check what could be the potential problems or bad habits that can cause injuries. As soon as you're already in the injury, that's quite hard to get out of there, and especially without help and without teacher. So that is much easier to prevent it. And bad habits, they go into our playing process very easy and very fast, especially when you don't have a good teacher. I see so often there are self-taught guitarists who have incredibly big angles in the left hand, and after some time they said, I have pain here, I'm not able to play anymore, what's happened? All these things happen much earlier than you might think, and much more often. So please inform yourself what could be the trouble things and try not to do them. This is, of course, also some kind of concentrate of some of important things, and you can add other points that you think might be important if you learn by yourself, if you don't have a teacher. And now we will go to the third point, which tools could be useful if you a self-taught guitarist, and what might help you on your way to success. So now let's check the tools that might be helpful in your self-study. Tutorials, for example, on YouTube or on other platforms, huge amount. The most difficult is to choose the right one. Masterclasses or participation in the masterclasses online, but also live. I'm talking about active participation, but also about passive participation. Be aware that also passive participation might bring you many interesting inputs, even if you don't play by yourself directly, but you listen to anybody else. Another point, listen to music and especially other instruments. As guitarists, we are used to listen to a lot of guitar music, and that is helpful in the beginning, but that might be not so helpful later. I can only encourage you to listen to piano music, to orchestral works, to violin, to violoncello, all possible chamber ensembles. That is very helpful and very educational from the side of music understanding, how to build the piece, phrasings. Phrasings works usually much better on other instruments than on the guitar, where you can hear them much more clear. Dynamics, different stylistics. All this information you can get by just listening experience of other instruments. One inside tip, if you learn the piece and you know that it was originally written, for example, for piano, and you play just like a transcription for the guitar, check the original version, the original performance. That might bring you different insights, different inputs, not the thing that you usually hear on the guitar and not the bad habits that you usually hear on the guitar. Participate in community and exchange with other people. You will find some interesting insights and maybe some helpful tips also. Take single lessons. That brings you also inputs. If you don't have a regular teacher, that is still very good to take from time to time some lessons. That might be master classes, or that could be a regular teacher on a regular basis. But that will help you a lot. Perform. That shouldn't be a great concert, but that might be a very small performances for family or friends. That also gives you absolutely different experience, and you learn the piece absolutely different. You prepare it differently if you know that you want to perform it. Last point, but not least, motivation through favorite pieces. That is definitely the greatest locomotive that brings you forward and that encourages you to practice if you really felt in love with a particular piece of music, then you're ready to study it from morning till the evening. But huge but, the favorite pieces, especially if you are self-taught, might be not such pinky and nice Trojan horse as we have, but it could be a huge, dark, super powerful Trojan horse. Why? You need to learn to assess your technical and musical abilities very well, so that when you choose the favorite piece, that you can really bring it to a particular level that will give you a lot of joy. Unfortunately, very often I see the cases where the beginner hears Alhambra or Asturias, these more typical examples, and without having any technical basis or in general musical basis, it starts to learn and works hard, but it doesn't sound so good. And if this phase of not sounding good with all your power and all your encouragement, if it takes too long time, you can become depressed and frustrated because it's some kind of just you lost. So be aware of this Trojan horse and try to assess your abilities well, or try to make a plan how you can get to your favorite piece. I thank you so much for your attention. I hope that was helpful. Don't forget to put like, to comment, to subscribe, and to press the reminder bell button. And thank you so much to all my patrons on patreon.com for your support. And I can encourage you to join our community. You'll find the many other lessons, masterclasses, online concerts, and the great community with which you can exchange. Thank you very much, and see you next time.